Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We are going to talk about alkyl halides. Alkyl halides are the organic molecules that undergo our four key reactions, SN1, SN2, E1, E2, and so we need to define some terminology around alkyl halides. On the screen, I have four different types of alkyl halides drawn. They range from this methyl halide to these other three, and these are categorized by their degree of substitution. So on the methyl halide, this carbon is attached to a halogen, X, and halogens are typically, as we go to the upper right, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. We'll qualify that in a moment, but this halide is attached to a carbon. The halide itself will always be attached to just one carbon, but when we talk about degree of substitution, we are discussing how many carbons are attached to that halide bearing carbon. So this carbon is attached to zero other carbons. We call that a methyl. If our carbon attached to the halide is attached to one other carbon, and it doesn't have to be a methyl, it could be an ethyl, propyl, hexyl, it could be anything, but it's attached to one other carbon, we call it primary, and we say it, or sometimes people write one with a degree sign because we're talking about degree of substitution. Secondary, we have the carbon bearing the halide is attached to two different carbon groups. That's secondary, or you could write 2 degree. And then tertiary, we have 3 carbons. So the methyl group is less substituted, and the tertiary carbon is more substituted. In fact, it's the most substituted. So what are the effects of substitution? What do you get when you have a higher degree of substitution? Well, you encounter steric effects. For some of these reactions, we're going to want to do chemistry on this carbon, this central carbon that bears the halogen. It's more crowded if we have a tertiary carbon. Therefore, sterics come into play. It makes these collisions between molecules less productive because there's just more stuff around that carbon. So sterics are a factor. When we talked about carbocations, if you remember learning about carbocations, we also talked about degree of substitution then. So more substitution can help stabilize carbocation formation. And in some of our reactions, we're going to form carbocations. So degree of substitution isn't just about sterics, which we tend to think as a bad thing, but it also can actually help formation of carbocations. Now, halides are important for these reactions because for all these reactions, we need a good leaving group. We need a stable anion. And what group of elements tend to make stable anions is the halogens. Chloride, bromide, iodide, these all make really stable anions. So these are good leaving groups. And sometimes I'll lazily just write LG, leaving groups. Now, when we talk about good leaving groups, one halogen stands out, fluoride. Fluoride is not a good leaving group. It's a halogen, but it doesn't make a really stable anion. Fluoride's actually pretty reactive. It's pretty basic. It's unstable. Unstable how? It's basic. So it's not a good leaving group. So as we talk about halides, alkyl halides specifically, these are halides attached to sp3 hybridized carbons. We will discuss generally chlorine, bromine, and iodine. We will leave alkyl fluorides out of this discussion. But this is some language that we'll frequently encounter as we talk about these four different reactions in the context of alkyl halides.